Hi everyone. I just wanted to take some time to make this video because I wanted to capture my story, my journey over the past couple of weeks. It was triggered a couple of Fridays ago when I was admitted to hospital in a pretty critical, life-threatening state. And importantly, I wanted to capture some thoughts and reflections that have made a huge difference for me, and wanted to share that with you because I'm passionately believing in it. But I'll get to that in a second. It's worth just giving, I suppose, a bit of context as to this past 2 weeks, this extraordinary roller coaster I've been on. To those that know me as a passionate cyclist. So I do my best to look after myself, live well, sleep well, eat well. That gives me the best chance to really enjoy the, I think it's on average 12,000 kilometers a year on the bike. However, this year has turned out, differently. I started it in Girona. I had 2 months planned to be in this wonderful town in Catalonia in Spain, remote working and cycling every day, with the goal of trying to get as strong and as fit as possible for a race that I'm meant to be doing in July in Israel and captaining the Dutch team. But those 2 months didn't really work out as I planned. I just seemed to end up with this continual series of strange health anomalies and symptoms that I just really couldn't explain. Things from fatigue and then getting over that and having a groin strain and then getting over that and then having muscle spasms in my back and then getting over that. And then working with my coach, my amazing coach, to try and work out what was going on and adjust my training plan and take things down a bit. So I was doing more walking and then yoga, but then I felt really good after doing yin yoga, but the next day my body would be like 100 years old. Super strange. And then unfortunately came off a slippery bend off my bike and damaged my shoulder. I ended up having an MRI that showed I'd done a minor rupture of my trapezium, but not only that, I've got a swollen lymph node around here. And the Spanish doctors are recommending I get it checked out when I get back to Amsterdam. So that's what I did in March. I went to see my local doctor and I was got some blood tests done. But then on the day, one of the days, I had a blood test where they seemed to be taking a huge amount of blood. At the end of the day, my arm started to feel really floppy and like treacle running through it. And I was thinking, this feels a bit odd, but probably due to the 16 vials of blood the clinic took. So I was like, okay, well, we'll just put that to the side. And then reassuringly, a couple of days later, I did a cycling fitness test and ended up with results that I was actually quite surprised by. Not at the level I wanted to be, but it was better than I thought. So I was like, okay, maybe the body's recovering, getting over this weird shopping list of symptoms. And then that weekend, I went on a ski trip, and on the penultimate day, lunchtime, I felt super tired and really low energy, exhausted, and stomach ache. So I spent the rest of the afternoon and that night in my hotel room. And like everyone seems to think at the moment, anything you've got wrong with you, it's COVID. So I was like, okay, well, let's just put it down to COVID and also a couple of hard days skiing. So the next day, flew back to Amsterdam, did PCR tests, and showed I didn't have COVID. But then that week, I was just super tired. And also just other little things. I was seeing optician because I had some things I couldn't really explain about my vision that didn't feel right. I was seeing a podiatrist because I've got one leg longer than the other and trying to sort out orthotics. I was seeing physio for my shoulder. So I really felt like a walking hospital case. Well, yeah. And then on the Friday morning, so a couple of Fridays morning, a couple of Fridays ago, that's when I woke up with quite worrying symptoms. So I had like unexplained bruising all over my body, including things like this, and blood blisters on my tongue, and blood mouth ulcers, and specks of blood in clusters on my skin. And went to see my local doctor, and they were, okay, this is pretty serious. We need to get you to first aid in the hospital as soon as possible. So I ended up at the hospital and getting blood tests done and CT scans. And that was when it was revealed that I had really critical, life-threateningly low blood levels. So my platelets, which for most normal people should be above 150, were below 3. And that's critical for basically your platelets help your blood coagulate. And when they're that low, they just, your blood doesn't, can easily, you bruise and easily bleed. So anything could be happening internally that you're not aware where you're bleeding out. And my hemoglobin levels, which should be above 8 for most normal people, and when they get down to 7, 6.5, big red flag is raised, and mine was at 3.6. And so it was critical. But in some strange way, fortunately at the time, I didn't really realize the significance of this, so I didn't have that medical knowledge of blood levels and what they meant. So I wasn't particularly alarmed or panicked. I was just very weak and low energy. But they were like, okay, this is super serious. We need to admit you to hospital. And that's from there when I started like 2-3 days of transfusions and infusions to take me out of the critical state, to stabilize me, and then tests with CT scans and bone marrow biopsies and lymph node biopsies to start to get the information to explain what's going on. And it was then diagnosed that I had this disease, this rare disorder, which is called autoimmune hemolytic anemia, which is basically where your immune system produces antibodies that attacks your own blood cells and platelets and destroys them, and a mild lymphoma. And that's why I then have ended up on 5 days of chemotherapy treatment, which has also led me to have the utmost respect for those people going through chemotherapy. It is brutal and horrid and debilitating. But this whole experience has left me with two lasting themes of reflections, and one of which is had their the nurses and the doctors and the specialists and the paramedics that looked after me are just simply angels. They, what they do every day to look after and care for people is just another level, and we all know it, but until you're experience it, it's really just, incredibly humbling. I felt being looked after, attended to, they're super patient, empathetic, answer any questions, just genuinely look after you in the most selfless way it seems possible. And the specialists do an incredible job of explaining quite complicated medical situations in a way that you understand, you can empathize, but not feel anxious or alarmed by, or that's the feeling I had. So could not be more grateful for them. And so to any doctor, nurse, paramedic, specialist out there, hats off to you. You are amazing, wonderful human beings, and I think everyone are super grateful for you. And then the other observation is around the extraordinary, overwhelming, in a good way, humbling experience of the help and support that I've received from not only people that are close to me, but also people that I didn't expect, who've just been wonderful with their generosity, and it's just a wonderful surprise. And what I found in me, and this is really the point of making this video, and the message I'm really trying to share, is around this concept of, I think of it as the gift of asking for help, or at least then being vulnerable enough to receive it and then be grateful for it. Because I used to be that type of person who would perhaps be like, no, I'm okay, I'll manage, I don't want to be a burden, I'll be independent, I'm fine, and not be instinctively open to ask for help or willing to accept the offer. And this experience now over the past couple of weeks has just completely changed that, and that the nearly like the beauty of being able to have a mindset of accepting any offer, accepting any person who's wanting to help in any way, is a gift. And the reason why I put it as a gift is because not only, clearly I'm going to benefit, anyone receiving support and help and love or anything I can do to help, you feel great, looked after and cared for in someone's thoughts. But then the person who's offering it clearly gets a buzz, gets a feel-good factor, however it might be. Either it's a sense of like, I'm just helping my, someone, my fellow human being, someone close to me, a sense of pride or whatever it is, but they feel good as a result. So to be open to and then receive and be grateful for that act of generosity and that offer of help is a way to give the opportunity for someone else to feel good, and it's a win-win. And how beautiful is that? And how simple is that? And it exists in abundance out there in terms of the people in your world who want to do this. They have an instinct. It's like a reminder that people instinctively want to do to help, to want to do good, to want to offer support. And this is the massive game-changing mindset change and reminder I'm giving myself. And this is the whole point, I think, of this video that I'm wanting to share and put the message across around, the gift of asking for help and being vulnerable enough to receive it, accept it, and be grateful for it. Because to do so is giving this opportunity, is initiating this nearly like sort of social contract where both of you are gonna benefit. The person that offers this has an opportunity to feel good. And that in itself is super powerful, but then the ripple effect of it makes it exponentially even more powerful. So as a result of that, they feel good and are gonna be potentially more willing and wanting to offer help and be generous the rest of their day, and potentially also willing and recognize the benefit of asking for help. So they've triggered another opportunity for someone else to help them who's gonna feel good, and so on and so on. So it's this incredible, beautiful situation where we've got a moment and a chance in every day of our lives to trigger this ripple effect. And how amazing is that? And that's the point of this video, that I want to share this reflection, this message, that perhaps either for yourself, like me, you're stubborn and don't necessarily so easily welcome and receive offers of help, because you think of yourself as quite independent and self-reliant. Or there's other people who are like that. It might help them or yourself. And it could be anything from the sort of smaller everyday things of just, allow someone to help you and you both win, to even the more serious you know, grave situations that I've been through where you're helpless and vulnerable, and then it's going to trigger it perhaps on a much more wider scale level to be just completely receptive to it. And it can be, and that the feeling I had was quite overwhelming, but the trigger and reminder I was giving myself was to accept it every time and be grateful. And it can be as small as just a saying, you know, a message that goes, I'm thinking of you, and is there anything I can do to help? And just replying to say, yeah, I so appreciate it. That's wonderful. Yes, I'll let you know. Through to the more bigger gestures. I've just been blessed by the support from my brother and my sister-in-law whilst I was going through chemotherapy. And them looking after me. So everything from the small to the big and everything in between. So this is the point I was trying to share. And I hope this message is resonating with you, or perhaps someone you may know that you want to share this with. It would be wonderful if this can reach out to as many as people as possible and have the chance to change that mindset, because it's powerful, it's in abundance, and it feels so simple and effortless, and it's a huge opportunity to change things and spread the opportunity for feeling good, which can only be a positive, right? And yeah, the spirit of this is reminding me of a wonderful phrase that is used by Simon Sinek, who does this absolutely wonderful podcast series called A Bit of Optimism. And he ends every podcast with this wonderful phrase that is, take care of yourself and take care of each other. And I feel like over the past couple of weeks, I've lived this in its most profound and rich way. So clearly, by having this mindset change of receiving acts of generosity and kindness and support and help, I'm looking after myself. And by being open to the gestures and welcoming them into my life, I'm initiating an opportunity for others to take care of each other. And the phrase has resonated on an exponential level more over these past couple of weeks. And if I could summarize, I suppose, the spirit of this in that phrase, that's the way I would do it. So to everyone out there, take care of yourself and take care of each other. Thanks again for listening, and yeah, please feel free to share this with as many people as possible. Thank you very much.